foreign direct investment plays a crucial role in my country, powering the development in my country. As it is known, in 2011, my country grew at the rate of 14.1% of GDP, and both the World Bank and the IMF adjudged Ghana's economy to be the fastest growing economy in the world, and has also projected that Ghana, alongside nine other countries, will be the fastest growing economies in the world in the next 10 years. So it is important for us to sustain the flow of foreign direct investment into our country and to increase its tempo, really, so that we can continue to grow our development. The Middle East, clearly, is one big source of foreign direct investment. Following the financial crisis in the West and the economic meltdown, there's a lot of surplus capital in the Middle East looking for a home. And we want to project our country as a preferred destination for Middle East capital. Ghana is one of the newest oil producing countries. So the oil and gas sector of our economy will require a lot of injection of foreign direct investment, both in the upstream and downstream levels. The entire value chain in the oil sector and gas sector is calling for investment, for exploration, for exploitation of the oil, for the petrochemical industry. We believe that we need to inject a lot of capital to make the best out of the resource for our nation's development. I would say that there is a deficit, really, in terms of power generation. We are basically relying on hydropower. That's the main resource from the Volta Dam, which has served us well for several decades. But today, with the upsurge in industrialization, we believe that we need to augment the levels of power generation in our country. So it is one area where we really are looking to attract a lot of foreign direct investment for us to be able to close the gap and produce sufficient power, energy to power our industries. Our biggest trading partner traditionally has been the United Kingdom, our former colonial masters, and of course the United States of America and Japan. But with the diversification that we are undertaking now, we are operating an open door policy, and therefore we are inviting investors from all across, from China especially, and from the Korea, from Southeast Asia and the Middle East, and across the world, really. We have joint commissions for cooperation with many African countries and even beyond, with other countries of the world. We are engaged with them negotiating bilateral agreements, you know, because we believe that we need to grow our economy to be robust, to be resilient, and to produce decent jobs, sustainable jobs, and therefore we need to go out there and collaborate with countries that are willing to partner with us in that particular regard. And therefore, we are really engaged in negotiations with various countries. There are particular agreements that are very substantial and clearly will make the difference in our situation. And therefore, we give some priority attention to them. Recently, my president was in the United States of America as an official guest of the U.S. government, and Ghana had been selected among four nations across the world to benefit from the Partnership for Growth initiative of the U.S. And that comes right on the heels of the U.S. Compact One under the Millennium Challenge account. That Ghana was a beneficiary and did extremely well. And therefore, that particular negotiation was very crucial for us. Ghana is a trailblazer. We are accustomed to leadership responsibilities in Africa generally. As you know, Ghana was the first African country south of the Sahara to attain independence from the colonial administration. And Ghana was also the catalyst for other countries to equally throw off the yoke of colonialism. And therefore, politically, we were looked upon as the leaders the black star of Africa, really. And today, we believe that Ghana is also now leading in the area of democracy, because Ghana is seen as a beacon of African democracy. Equally, our human rights pedigree has come to the attention of the world, as well as Ghana's management, sustainable management of the economy. Ghana has a reputation of maintaining a very peaceful, stable political environment, very secure, and also with strong institutions, democratic institutions. Our Electoral Commission, for instance, has been able to conduct 5 successful elections, which have been declared to be transparent and credible. 2 of them actually ended in transiting power from a ruling government to the opposition, which is very significant, really. And therefore, we also believe that we should export the peace that we have, you know, because Ghana is a credible member of the UN system, and we believe in international peace and security. And therefore, Ghana has been very prominent in peacekeeping activities of the United Nations as the 6th largest contributor of peacekeepers in the world, really.